Logically, there's some added power under the hood to back this up. The Adreno 509 graphics are only about 10% faster when you stack them up against the 630, but the Cryo 260 CPU is about 40% faster. You are probably going to notice the difference with intensive tasks. Don't expect a complete revolution when the 630 was still brand new half a year ago, though. You are still getting the familiar 600 megabits per second LTE support, and the Spectra 160 image signal processor delivers the same photo-taking quality. This is ultimately a speed bump, it's just one that will have a very visible effect on mid-range Android phone designs. Qualcomm isn't naming customers, but it's shipping the 636 to phone makers in November. And importantly, companies can use it on boards that were originally intended for the 630 or 660. If your favorite brand wants to make an ultra-wide phone at a modest price, it can reuse the innards from an existing design and put the new device in your hands that much sooner.